Welcome to Daniel Workshop. Today I'm going to sharpen a carving knife. I got it from a friend of mine and he told me that it's not cutting anymore, and if I can help him and sharpen it. As you see, it's not cutting, it's just tearing the paper up. So what I'm going to use today to sharpen it, it's a combination stone, no name combination stone, Chinese one. What I did, I dropped it on this corner and it got cracked, but I can still use it. So we're going to use this stone. It's a soaking stone. I've already used it on some other things and it works nice. What I'm trying to do now is to open a bottle of water to put some water on the stone and leave it to soak for a few minutes. As you see, bubbles are coming out. Like I said, I've already used it on some other things and it's quite okay for day-to-day jobs as sharpening knives or things like that. I didn't try it on finer things like chisels or something like that, but I might try it one of these days. So I'll leave it to soak for about 5 to 10 minutes after no bubbles are coming out. So I'm just going to pause the movie and I'll be back when it's all done. All right, so soaked, no more bubbles coming out. So we will get, I meant to say get back, but we never were. So we're going to get sharpening. I'm going to sharpen it. I just marked the edge with the marker, and we'll be using the 1000 grit, the red one first. I'm going to set it in my whetstone holder that I made myself. If you want to know how I made it, you just watch the movies on my channel. I hope it's interesting for you. All right, let's add some water. All right, like I said, with these soaking stones, all the time just add water to have plenty of water on the stone. Okay, first things first, let's find the edge. We set the knife on the stone and then raise it up a little until it grabs. So more or less that's the angle. And we're going to check it. See, the marker is gone. So just did 10 of them and I'm checking the edge. I think there is something on the tip. See, it was over sharpening or something, but we don't have any burr. So we'll be doing a few back and forward movement, and I'm trying to keep the edge as constant as I can. Okay, I just did another 10 and I feel some burr in the middle, but nothing here, nothing on the tip. Okay, the over sharpening from the tip, I don't know if you can see it. There is a, yeah, no, you can see it. There is something on the tip, like when it was pulled from the, let me put some tape on on this ferrule so I don't scratch it, or I don't scratch it very bad. Maybe I should do it like this. No, it's not working. Okay. Try to go around. Okay, that's okay. So now I'm not. I don't have to worry about the not touching the ferrule. Just back and forward movements on the tip, and then I move on the middle, and now on the back of the blade. I have burr, and just a little on the tip. Okay, let's do the other side. Ten. And now push-pull movement. I'm trying to use all the surface of the stone so it doesn't dish out. Okay, let's clean it a little and see what's happening. Okay, I have burr, burr, burr. Here I don't have so much burr. All right. Okay, so now we have to get rid of the burr by doing alternative movements. Okay, I just did 20. Don't feel burr on the edge, and now it's cutting. It's not tearing the paper out, so I think I'll stop it a little, and then I'll move to the finer side. I'll be stropping it with a little hard compound. I have two types of compounds. A rough one, this is the green one, which is a little rougher, and I have a white one, which is a little softer. Not softer, finer. Okay, finer, that's the correct word. I like to do this stropping in between, moving from one grid to the other, because like this, I'm sure that there is no more burr on the blade from the previous grid. Also now it's cutting very nice. So what I'll be doing now is just polishing the blade on the 3000 grid. What I like to do now, because this is a combined stone, combination stone, I like to clean the stone under running water, because as you can see, there are some contaminants from the 1000, and I'm not sure if any got here on the 3000, so better clean it well, and then get back to sharpening on the 1000. So I'll be back. So I've rinsed it on the running water, under running water, so now I'm sure there is no contaminants or particle from the 1000 side. And now we'll be moving, and we will be doing just some cleaning of the blade, polishing of the blade, so we'll not be doing any sharpening. So we'll just go, I forgot to mark it. Not be doing the push-pull movement, just the stropping type movement, just to polish the blade. Okay, I just did 30. I'll be doing some more till I have 50. Okay, so that's 50. And now we're going to strop it on the stone. Okay, so I just did 30 strop-like movements, not against the bevel, not against the edge, but opposite backside movements. So more or less, I'm finished with the stone. So now I'll be moving to the strop. Let's clean the water on the table. All right. So let's see how it is on the paper before stropping. Should be okay. Yeah, it's okay. It cuts. So now we're going to strop it on the rougher compound first. So I just did 10 on one side, 10 on the other side, and 20 alternatives, one side and the other side. Let me take the other strop with the white compound and add some more compound, just a little, and do the same thing. 10. So I did 10 on one side, 10 on the other side, and then 20 alternatives once, or that was my purpose. So we sharpen it, we stropped it, and now let's test it. Get a similar piece of paper as the one we previously tested. And as you can see, cuts like nothing. Trying to round it up. See if I can, if I can. Now I can. Hey. So let's cut a little more. I like to cut the paper after I sharpen something. I just like to just destroy the paper. It's fun for me. That's the most fun part of the sharpening. I mean, after I sharpen something, to just cut the paper around and around and around and around in smaller and smaller pieces. And I get a nice feeling when I see that I can get cut paper without a problem after I sharpen a knife or some cutting tool. All right, so let's see if it shaves. I hope you can see it. Pieces of hair just popping out, and see, that's a hair, piece of hair there. So it's also shave. It's not its purpose. I mean, it's not a razor blade, so we are not going to shave with it, but shaves hair, it cuts paper like nothing. So I think it's good enough for a carving tool. Yeah, I'm going to give it to my friend and see how he likes it. I hope he likes it. I hope you enjoy it. Till next time, take care. If you like my movie, just click like, subscribe, or whatever button you like there. Leave me a comment if you want to ask me something. And till next time, take care and have a nice day.